I've got a quick question for you today. Do you feel that with today's online world, what it is, that your privacy is somehow being compromised? Duh! Is my privacy being compromised? The question is, how do I limit how much my privacy is compromised? Today, we are going to talk to iPhone users whose privacy, I have to tell you, is not number one on the list of priorities at Apple. Oh, no, no, no. As a matter of fact, it seems that Apple is bound and determined to undermine any efforts that we make to ensure our own privacy. What am I talking about today? Well, have a look at today's video. Get the heck out of my kitchen, Apple. There can be no doubt that smartphones are amazing tools that give us some tremendous capabilities if we enable all of the different features. But one of the features that is built into our smartphones deals with knowing where we are in physical space, location services. And location services can create all sorts of nightmares as far as privacy is concerned. And Apple, for one, and by the way, all of you Android and other phone users, don't be smirking at the poor Apple folk because thinking, oh, my operating system is so much better than Apple's as far as privacy. They all suck. They all suck big time as far as privacy is concerned. But Apple, well, they've got some special things happening within the Apple world. Now, what I want to talk to you today is about dealing with the location services and making sure that they're not tracking you when you don't want to. Because if you don't go dive deep into the bowels of your iPhone and turn off some settings, Apple can actually track and generate a profile of almost everything you do, where you are, what you're doing, what time it is. They can collect it all. And I don't know about you, but it makes me rather uncomfortable. And it's not right there on the surface. Here's the thing that bugs me. These settings shouldn't be multiple levels deep within the iPhone. No, no, no. They should be right on the surface. So let me go back. So where we're going to go is we're going to go into our settings. We're going to go into our privacy settings. We're going to go into location services, and if you've had your iPhone for any length of time whatsoever, you've got tons of these location services that are turned on or off. And most people just go through this and they decide what they want to have turned on. I mean, you want to have, you know, for example, you want to have Safari knowing where you are. You want the reminders to know where you are because you want it to know, because you often create notes based on location. But if you go down to the very bottom, this is the spot that I wanted to talk to you about. System services. These services, if you don't go in and modify them, Apple can basically create a profile which tells them everything about you. Far too much information. So the first thing that you look at is, see this little kind of, it's a legend here. This tells you when we go into the next screen what services have been accessed in the last period of time. So purple ones mean just in the last little while. A gray icon says that it's been within the last 24 hours, etc. So you want to read those and take a look, because here are the different services that they have turned on within the our iPhone. And the ones that we want to turn off right away is, first of all, diagnostics and usage. Because this, if we leave diagnostics and usage on, our iPhone anonymously sends Apple information about everything that we do. Literally everything. Now, they say it's anonymous. So theoretically, it doesn't know that I'm Steve Dotto, but it knows that this phone is doing those things. And it's basically creating a diary of every activity that you make. And they'd say that they do this so that they can improve iOS and they can improve customer service. What a load of, well, I'm not going to say it because they might actually use it to improve customer service at times. But let's face it, what they're improving is they're improving their ability to sell to us at the end of the day. That's really what Apple's interested in improving. So without hesitation, off with diagnostics and usage. Location-based iAds. How in the world did that get buried 15 levels deep? Okay, I exaggerated. 3-4 levels deep in the iPhone. Turn off these so that you're not getting all those irritating little banners being sent to you. So right away, just in a few seconds, I found two settings that I don't want to have turned on. Not only are they invading my privacy and sending content to me that I probably don't really want to have, but they're also using up my battery. They're also using up my services, and they're also using up my data plan. I don't want any of those things to be happening. And while we're at it, what is this frequent locations thing? It's turned on. What does it do? It allows my iPhone to learn places I frequently visit in order to provide useful location-related information. If I frequently visit a location, chances are I'm doing it for a reason and I already know what's going on at said location. Off! There we go. We have taken the first step towards recapturing some of our privacy. I'm feeling a little more transparent as we speak. Okay, let's go back up. So let's go back into the privacy settings one more time and take a look at this one here, which seems to slide by people quite a bit. We go to privacy. Look there. Why is it always at the bottom? They hide it down there. Limit ad tracking. What's this all about? You know, you turn this on and off, and look, nothing happens. They don't give you any explanation. You actually have to dive in here to learn more in order to find out more. And Apple, they are such good writers. They've got a whole legal team that writes these things. They're excellent at the use of verbiage. But essentially, I will paraphrase for you. Ad tracking allows advertising networks to understand who you are, a little bit about your age, your demographic, the same sort of stuff, information as you say you're getting from Facebook. You know, when you're on Facebook, they look at your profile, they look at what you're posting about, and then they customize the ads that are delivered to you to more fit your profile. Fine. I don't necessarily hate that concept. Heck, I do some advertising online myself, so I'd be speaking out of two sides of my face if I said that this was all bad. What I don't like about this is the fact that this is a tool that you have to turn on in order to protect your privacy, when everything else you have to turn off in order to protect your privacy. Think about what we were just looking at. They had all these tools turned on that were tracking us, so we had to go in and disable them. Now Apple flips the metaphor completely on us, and we have to turn this on as opposed to turning it off. You know what I'm saying? They're muddying the waters and confusing us by doing it this way. But that's me. That's just my attitude towards it. I think we should have a standard convention. Apple is all, after all, about standardizing interface, but here they've broken their own rule. Having said that, if you turn on limit ad tracking, you will probably receive the same amount of ads delivered to you in different services, in different apps that you use. They just won't know quite as much about you as they do now. So it won't be quite as targeted. You'll be getting more general ads. Now, the benefit is, I don't know if there's a real benefit to you, because they've basically told us we're going to get the same number of ads. It's just whether or not you want to protect your privacy a little bit more and not have ads delivered to you that are custom tailored to you. That's going to be a personal choice that you make. But it just kind of, the reason I'm showing you it is it kind of cheeses me off a little bit that Apple hit it down there and then they then change the metaphor. So that's two areas that we've looked into where we can protect our privacy a little bit more. What's next, Steve? Have I whetted your appetite? The last area that I want to talk to you about today is, call me a little bit of, I don't know if I need to wear tinfoil on my head to be concerned about this, but these are the apps that you give access to your microphone for. So these are apps that can gain access to listen into your microphone. So I would take a look at this list of apps that's been enabled and make sure that you haven't installed something that's kind of flaky, something a little bit more concerned. I'm taking a look at these apps and they all, Instagram, I don't really do voiceovers on Instagram, so I can disable that. I think I'll do that right now. I'll disable that. Human to cat translator, that's just a fun thing that makes me meow like a cat. So, sorry. Evernote, definitely need a microphone for. Google for the voice stuff. Google Maps, Translate, which is something, SimpleClap, which is a tool. You know, I don't need to use that in it either. And Songify, which is a fun game that I play. So those are the only apps that have access to my microphone. Just something worth sharing. You know, protecting your privacy has become something that we have to become experts on. It's extra bandwidth that we have to consume as far as knowledge, which is, it's kind of unfair to a certain extent that the mobility carriers and that all of these high-tech companies are taking advantage of their systems in order to invade our privacy this way, enforcing us to spend time to learn to basically protect what used to be something taken for granted. We can complain about it till the cows come home, but the bottom line is that it's not going to change and it's only going to get worse. So the farther behind you are when you start paying attention to privacy issues, the more catch up you're going to have to do. So if you've watched this video to this point here, well, you're well on the path. It means that you're concerned and you're paying attention and you're starting to take control and you're asking the questions and educating yourself. So do us all a favor, educate your friends a little bit about it. One great way is share this video. Let them know about this video, any iPhone friends that you have, and tell them, hey, you should take a look at this and make sure that you turn off these things on your iPhone and pay attention to it. Oh, look, there's Farley on my screen saying, don't forget to protect your privacy. That's all the time that I have today. I hope that this video has been tremendously useful for you. If it has, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel. And if you are so inclined, we would love you to become one of our Patreon supporters. These videos are supported by the community, and that is you. I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.